MSS technology. Example cases in construction, city planning, agriculture, disaster management, and others. We have several distinguished speakers. I would like to invite Mr. Takenori Kato from TOPCon Corporation. He works for TOPCon Singapore, positioning as senior manager, taking care of Southeast Asia market. He has an experience for Asian survey and mapping market, such as managing director of TOPCon Tokyo India. Next, I would like to invite Ms. Bentama C. Pignol from Nishio Rent All. Her position is marketing sales manager. She has worked for Nishio Rent for 18 years. Her job is to present 3D MC system to customers. Her main responsibility is to connect with construction companies. Next, we have Mr. Akira Nagao from Asia Technology Industry. He had done advanced research at Honda for 30 years before he left the company last September. Then he has come to Thailand to work with Thai people using his experience and knowledge. Mr. Rakshit Thittithattanapong is a GNSS specialist, a licensed mechanical engineer, and the co-founder and chief of operations of Infinite Solar Technology, engaging in GNSS, GIS, and satellite-related technology. He also functions as assistant project director, WBCSD Mobility Bangkok Saturn Model. In addition, he served an engineering fellow at Smart Mobility Research Center, Faculty of Engineering, Jalalongkorn University, on many technical development projects. Next, I would like to invite Ms. Piraya Tanti Anupa from Hydro and Agroinformatics Institute, Thailand. Ms. Piraya is the Secretariat of the Thai-Japan Working Group on GNSS for Water and Disaster Management. And lastly, we have Dr. Hiroyuki Miyasaki from University of Tokyo, the moderator of the session. He received Doctor in Philosophy degrees and Environmental Studies from the University of Tokyo, Japan in 2011. Since 2012, he has been an infrastructure specialist in the Asian Development Bank, Philippines, as a secondee from the University of Tokyo. Since 2015, he has been a project assistant professor in the University of Tokyo, as well as visiting assistant professor in the Asian Institute of Technology, Thailand. His research interests in applications of geospatial and space technologies for development issues, such as urban development, disaster risk management, public health, project management, agriculture, and water resources management. Please put your hands together and welcome moderators and panelists on stage.
Thank you very much for your participation in this session. So it is my honor to the moderate this session. So I'd like to start with my introduction to the about of this session before the speeches by the experts. So could you show my slide? So in this session, the applications, constructions, agriculture, disaster management, or other everything. So I understand that the Thailand 4.0 is for the needs certain innovations. So let me introduce about the innovations. So the innovations. Everyone that thinks about the Steve Jobs, for example, the world leading innovators who developed the iPhones and smartphones and iPads. He made the computers for everyone. So now the even the children that use the computers, iPhones and so on, and everyone connected. So, but the that is not his original ideas. Actually, the such ideas or vision has been already proposed 45 years. While in such old days, computers should be so large, large scale instruments. So I can say that we need the vision for the promotions of the GNSS technology for everyone, like this. So here's the image of the Thailand GNSS technologies for 4.0. So we have been talked about a lot in the technology, but now it's time to how to discuss how to outreach the technology to the people. So and also the such for the Thailand 4.0, we need to develop by the Thai people. So I can say that common vision, shared vision would be the GNSS technologies of Thai people, by Thai people, and for Thai people to the outreach the technologies for the people's of happiness. So here's the list of the invited key speakers who are the key experts of the GNSS technologies in Thailand. To save the time, I'm just skipping. They already introduced in the beginning of this session. And I prepared key questions about key experts invited here. The first one is how is your vision of the technologies for the next 5 to 10 years? The second is what are the challenges for the realizing your vision? So we are going to discuss about these points. So please keep in mind these questions during these sessions. So I'd like to take my microphone to the first speaker, Mr. Kato.
Good morning, everybody. So I'm going to have my presentation. This is the one. So my presentation is for go to the network RTK technology powered by the codes. My presentation is jointly with the Topcon Corporation, which is my current company, and with the Genova. Is they are the service provider for to send in that codes collection data to the Japanese. In Japanese customers, they are having about over 50% share of this service, mainly very strong for the constructor and the surveyors. Then Topcon is making that this kind of the GPS receivers, but not only are we are producing that this kind of receivers. Sorry on that. So. Then we are making that receiver collecting that coordination data, and using that kind of technology, we are introducing that machine control system, and precision agriculture, and also the mobile mapping system, and UAV. Once the call station network implement into the country. We can provide this kind of the many different kind of the application using that the codes networks. So it will help the to increase that infrastructure job, increasing the productivity, reduce the time, reduce the material using that this kind of technology. We benefit a lot of the reducing that this kind of. Things. And again, that to implement that codes technology, one key point is to get very high accuracy positionings. As everybody mentioned that we are getting that accuracy up to a centimeter, even though sub centimeter levels. Then that we are such as kind of technology, we are utilize a lot of the applications such as the survey, machine control for construction, and also that hydro on the precision agriculture. And as everybody may aware, using that Japan Teams, using the help of the Japan Teams, we installed that coast station network in the, we call the TNet, entire of the Bangkok areas. The purpose is now Thai government itself is installing that coast systems, but to do that during the installation, after the installation, it may arise a lot of the that problem or things. So that's why we share that kind of information with each other to solve that these kind of problems. Also that to utilize this network, we want to test that some of the applications such as the machine control, agriculture, UAV, blah blah. So then now we are testing. We are going to introduce some example later, no? And also this system is open for all the Thai people. So once, if you want to utilize, and inside these networks, everybody can use test. What will be happen after course introduced in your country? So please contact to TOPCON, then you can utilize these networks. Then K10 ですね. It's a we install to the digital SKP inside of the SKP facilities. Then later on I explain that we are going to test for the machine control and the UAV inside this SKP facilities. Then I'd like to introduce that one of the movement in Japan. Now Japanese government, Ministry of Land, Infrastructure, Transportation, now and announcing the, this concept for the I constructions in 2015. Then that Japan actually facing that a lot of the shortage of workers and for construction. Also that try to government realize they are using this kind of technology. We can reduce a lot of the manpower, materials, and also the times. So that's why that the government now requesting the constructor to use this kind of technology. We call it I-constructions. Then the, in short, that the, what it means that the government accept use that the entire request to use that the 3D data from that design to the to finish. So then that you utilize this 3D data, then that we expect to shorten the times. Let's say for the survey part, previously just go and do the survey or do the survey job, but now government accept use that UAV or 3D scanners. Then it can be shorten the time, also that easily to take that 3D coordinate data. Then using for the design part, then for the construction part, using that this survey data and the design data, government request to use that machine control systems. Then the machine control later part, the she will explain more detail for the machine control system. Then that they utilize the government expect shorten the times. Then we utilize for the inspection part using for the again the UAV scanner or mobile mapping systems. And this is concept of the eye construction. Then the as I mentioned in the just the SKP side, now we are doing that test for that similar functionality of the machine eye construction. We do that. We will do that. 3D using the 3D motor graders to do the test inside that SKP site. thereafter, then we do that survey using that our UAVs. Then okay, so that we had one more very interesting testing here in Bangkok this time. We are using this cause networks. Unless then we generate and start space representation we call SSR, that we generate a similar data, similar collection data as the L62, which is centimeter level, as you are aware in the last session. Then that using that our TNet network, 10 receivers, 10 cause networks, then we calculate that L6 centimeter level data. Then that we run the car, put on the GPS, and run surround that Bangkok areas. Then the for the GPS, most of that area beside that very center of the Bangkok, we could fix that the GPS data about 70%. In the especially in the suburb area such as the near to the Suvarnabhumi Airport, the accuracy is much better. So it means that this now QZSS try to implement that L6 data meter and submeter correction data. It will be for our thought. It will be possible in Thailand areas. This is our tests. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for introduction of your technology. So in this session, I first ask the speakers to introduce their technology first, and then the discussions will follow. So may I ask Ms. Benjamin to introduce your technology.
Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone, and thank you very much for giving us the great opportunity. My name is Benjamin Sipinyo from Mitchell and all. From now, I would like to speak about network RTK 3D and machine control system and its advantage as a case example in construction aspect. According to iConstruction, allow 1,000 sites plan to use that model in 2017. I assume Thailand also will come to use like iConstruction model in near the future. 3DMC play an important role at construction stage. In Japan, around 300 sites used 3DMC in 2015. Among them, we support around 40% of them by rental. Regarding to current Thailand infrastructure investment, many projects are planned. The expansion of railway, airport, and seaport, and making the new highway so on. On the other hand, investment of a construction site is changing. For example, material cost is increasing. Titulation is in specification dropping of operator skill, and environmental consideration, so on. We assume high opportunity of DTMC system solve those problems at play alone in Thailand 4.0. I would like to explain to advantage of 3DMC system. In case of motocladder with RTK, NGSS, this system can control the blade automatically while combining GNSS positioning data and 3D design data. Furthermore, with the combination of cores, we save the cost of setting up at the base station. This should be almost nothing to do for operator, just only steering control. Operator doesn't require high skill on operating. And 3DMC system also enhance the user survey work at a construction site. In case of a continental works, worker have to make the benchmark point at 330 meter, even though and it less to surveyor or are needed to check its attribute. Hence, heavy machine operator and worker have to wait for next step until surveyor finish their job. But in case of GNC system, worker can check the cut and fill value everywhere on the work area by just pushing the GNSS lower on the cloud without surveyor acknowledge for by themselves. Moreover, if you can fit the work up to best cost with a high accuracy and flatness, you can save the material and make asphalt paving work more easily. In addition to that, load of cloud is able to maintain the good flatness a long time. From now, I want to explain to about to experiment and with using network RTK 3DMC system. At the beginning, we import 3D design data from Topcon's UAV system. Next, we check where is cut area, where is fill area, and calculate how much material being formed all the area in advance. Operator drive motor grader without benchmark and high operation skill. During motor grader working, we sometimes check the accuracy with using network RTK GNSS lower. In this way, we compare operating time and accuracy TDMC system with conventional way. I want to show this slide. Yes, sir. Actually, I want to video data for show to the 3DMC data, 3D system for motor grader for this video. Easier to you understand for this system.
For the technology introduction about from the initial rental, so that is so interesting in the automated construction. We will see the videos later. So the next, I direct to the pass my microphone to Mr. Nagao about the dynamic map.
Sorry, well, I really saw that. Looks like, okay. Then that's after that, so, the diagram here shows the necessary onboard function of the introduction of the semi-automatic car in Japan from 2020. And this diagram shows the classification of the four necessary so the components. Big portion, recognition and action plan, external recognition, big control. action plan, external recognition, and the vehicle control function, handle of the automobile related business, and is therefore or not a major concern. Okay. For the discuss, I would like to talk about the vehicle pollution recognition. The next diagram shows the configuration of the dynamic map and high accuracy satellite positioning system. This is the very important and difficult system. Speaking of the autonomous driving or car to car, every will agree that the high accuracy mapping and high accuracy positioning is necessary. In this way, not only the automobile industry, but the infrastructure also gets involved and can cost a lot of time and money, and maybe full of unnecessary problems. In Japan, team made up of Mitsubishi, also PASCO, and so maker, and developed a new product about the dynamic map. Here is the dynamic map overview. First of all, the dynamic map is a system necessary of the autonomous car and safety driving. It is a high accuracy 3D digital map which report car accident, road configuration, and weather has a high frequency of information update. The include vehicle movement and traffic high information, reservation map, and MMS. Which scans the entire infrastructure, like traffic, traffic light, road sign, everything, anything. So on the road, then create an accurate 3D map. We can just analyze the data and create a basic map. We will install on board dynamic data with high frequency of update necessary to operate the vehicle in order to create a dynamic map. That's all dynamic overview. So my making is also totally difficult, so many time, and there's also a problem. So yes, this is the mapping clear. And next talking is about high positioning, this positioning.
Position is sorry. Okay. Needed. So
the next how accuracy we need it. So that's so feature lane. I need so feature lane, so drive car positioning. The about so 3 meters so road so need accuracy so 1.5 meters. Then so we have so system so fusion with fusion, so the picture is also very interesting. So I made about 25 years ago. not changes this document about thinking. So 25 years. Let's look at 5 years from now. By 2020, Japan will already have begun operating on the autonomous full autonomous driving. However, it will be limited in the highways, and the will be seen as an extension of the existing ECC. I believe that the combining and dividing and lane change as it show in the diagram.
Thank you very much. So so interesting the technology for the urban traffic, which is the headaches, everyday headaches of the Thai people or Bangkok people. So innovative, I think. So I'd like to ask you, Mr. Laksit, for the introduction of his technology.
Actually, it's our work in collaboration with Kubo Sensei at Navigation Labs in Tokyo Marine Science and Technology. So that is the latest our find out from last month that we have conduct together and on rain recognition using the low cost CNSS. So what the importance of the low cost thing, because for decimeter level accuracy, so we can the receiver just cost around 100, 200 or $300 in comparison with survey grade centimeter level that cost at least $10,000 up. So it is possible to make many application, a lot of application, especially for the ITS. So that's why we are really interesting in, and then what we have done, it is we use the RTK technology, the single frequency RTK technologies. We use the TOPCon system, TOPCon the reference system around Bangkok. Also, we compare with the one of a reference system, which is collaboration between Chulalongkorn University and Tokyo universities. As a reference-based station system in comparisons. So this the test cost, the mainly is on the highway. We testing on the highway, and you know, the highway in the urban, the loop is the urban round, and also the suburban highway also the route that directly from the city to the Suvarnabhumi Airport. So okay, that's the summary. Maybe I skip this first. So the what we have done is we compare first the uBlox chips M8P, which is include the RTK calculation inside the chip. So we just connect directly to Topcon VRS system. Secondly, as a comparison, we use the uBlox, but another series is M8T for the raw data, and we gather those raw data and post-processing later with the Chulalongkorn base station for the RTK. And thirdly, we use also the same raw data from uBlox M8T, but calculate with the newer algorithm that they developed by TUMZ. So okay, this is the output for M8P that calculate inside the on the chip with Topcon VRS network. So the point is that interestingly, for in case of RTK, we have a few fixed point. However, mostly it's float point, but in good way, in good qualities. And also the results also show that we can get the accuracy around 90%, less than 1 meter. So which is up to our conclusions. Also, for authors find out with our reference thing, we can find out this with the reference station in based on Joule. We calculate for the another uBlox system on post processing. We can find out that up to 99% with accuracy around 0.75 across the testing. So briefly, we can tell you that now we can achieve this meter level accuracy with the infrastructure that already been installed in Bangkok. Also, another find out that in our testing condition, we find out that the communication, 3G communication in Bangkok is really good enough to carry out the correction data. Yes. Okay. That's fine.
Thank you very much. So I understand that the high-end accuracy is getting cheaper, affordable to the people. So it would be also potential innovations for the people. So let me move to the next two technology presentation by Ms. Pareja about disaster risk management and water resource management.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Pareja Tantenupap from Hydro and Agro Informatics Institute. Today, I would like to talk about as a user, I would like to use GNSS technology for water and disaster management. The next, what is our vision and mission related to water and disaster management? We would like to developing and apply science technology for is and then expand the success and strong and effective networking. In order to implement for Thailand 4.0 model, management and technology is required. Collaborative network is the key success for the mission of the water resource management, climate change, disaster management, and also the decision support system. And innovation, technology, creativity also test in service. We bring about the less for more. and economic growth. GNSS technology is the one of innovative technology that can be achieved for less for more in the sustainable. The next, I would like to talk about the GNSS core network can provide less time, less cost, less human resource, but it can give us higher precise positioning product for the surveying and mapping. As well as for IT construction, smart agriculture, transportation, and also for this slide, I would like to show the core network project. The project is belong to the DDPM, NIMT, and HAI. This project plan to service in the midst of this year. The next, I would like to talk about the GNSS application for disaster management. What we require from the GNSS, we require high accuracy, precise positioning and leveling for flood and disaster management, and for real-time data. It can apply for precise positioning and leveling for surveying and mapping product, real-time positioning service, MMS, UAV, deformation monitoring for infrastructure such as dam, and also we can use a GNSS data for weather observation. In the case of high precise positioning service, GNSS technology can apply with several platforms such as MMS, UAV, and also the automatic board to be as the tool for mapping, for hydro modeling, decision support system in the centimeter level accuracy on vertical and horizontal. Especially for horizontal is very important for the central part of Thailand. The next one, I would like to show the example of product from surveying and mapping using GNSS with high accuracy. The first one from MMS and from RTK network and also from UAV. In the last one, in the summary, GNSS technology is the effective technology which we can achieve for sustainability for the collaborative network as well as international collaboration is the key success. The knowledge sharing service and outcome give us the useful information as decision support system for disaster prevention and mitigation, and also sharing the good practice will be able as a hydro informatics and community water resource management. That's all what is we require from GNSS technology in the near future. Thank you.
Thank you very much for informative introduction. Thailand and Japan has a lot of the disasters, so it would be a common interest, good for the collaboration, the Thai-Japan the collaborations. So let me have just an announcement. Originally, this session is scheduled until the 12, but the secretary advised me we can have the until the by 12:30. So I would appreciate if you could stay in here. But I'm trying to make it compact. So the thank you for your cooperation. Okay, then let me move to the discussions. So I just do the in the beginning I gave some key questions. The first one is the vision. How is the vision of the technologies in the next 5 to 10 years? And the second one is the challenges to realize the visions. So I'd like to ask my answers to my questions first from Mr. Kato.
Yes. The vision for the 5 years, 10 years later, utilize this core network, this kind of the application to utilize with the wider and wider. So we have machine control, UAV, and agriculture. Not only that, likewise the previous session mentioned that the taxi cases, this kind of the new technology generated from the positioning technologies. Then the utilizing the high positioning technology, maybe some kind of the startup company may bring that new technology which we don't know. So that's why we expect that this kind of competition comes, then this application will be wider. Also, Topcon also thinking that some kind of new technology which we cannot disclose now, but we are exciting to utilize this kind of the closed networks. Then our company mainly for concentrate the construction part. Already most of that our instrument GPS total station, most of that instrument already in the IoT already ready. Then that we are even though that this kind of product is using in the construction field, but taking that all kind of data can be gathered into the one computer. So that's it. We are something like we are doing the construction, but control most of the things by the in the one of the inside office, some kind of things. Then utilizing that the virtual technology, the construction will be like more automations, like factory kind of. Now we call something like our product is a 3D printer in the construction field. So these kind of things are more already close to our hands.
Thank you very much. So I understand that as an infrastructure provider, Topcon, you need the applications such as constructions, and also that you may have another new fields.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Yes. We hope. So that's why not only us, a lot of idea may come from the maybe Thai also most probably like because of the course network is now implementing now. So then at the we generate a lot of new ideas to expand that. Since we should utilize this kind of networks.
Okay. So this table is very good place to connect with the applications.
Yeah, if you have some question, please let me know.
So I'd like to expand my our discussions to the applications. So could you may I ask you Ms. Benjamin about your vision as a application providers of the course?
Thank you very much for your question. I want to reply is have a vision or is it next to 5 or 10 years. We wish to government to agency to will have to recognize TDMC system, because TDMC system in Thailand is I think for all of people in the meeting room, difficult to understand like this for this system more. Actually, for my vision and for my company is have to demonstration for this system also. And I, for example, on this before yesterday, I have to demonstration at to Suvarnabhumi Airport, have a building to new phase in do like this. And is our customer and subcontractor come to doing for demonstration for the 3DMC system. And then customer in Thailand, I hope to, in this time, is interest in that demonstration. For my company also, I have to area for demonstration at Chonburi branch. You know, all of is construction, big construction also, if have to demonstration, I would to invite everybody come to here. I can show to my system of easy to understand for my system to presentation in this today. It's for that me.
Thank you very much. May I ask you I partially missed your talks, but if you already talked about, may I ask you some challenges or to-dos, such as demonstrations?
So
you are open to the people for giving the demonstrations for understandings of the technologies. So the video is ready. If you want to see the this video demonstrations in real, then please contact her. So let me have another questions. So the Mr. Castro suggested about the expanding their infrastructure for the for example the startup or some other the potential the innovators. So I understand the Mr. Nagao is a kind of a venture or startup company in Thailand. So I'd like to ask that if you have any issues, problems for the use of the course network or other high precisioning applications, if you have.
I want to talk about Japanese problem. I started doing the business in Thailand because my Japanese industry don't need engineer anymore. It takes so much time and money to train engineers. But for efficiency and profitability, Japanese industry has started to let go of many engineers. That is why I left Japan. I think I can be very useful in Thailand and so other Asia makers. And do I have a business model? Not necessary. I just whatever I can to the best of my ability. And that is all. Yes.
Okay. So then the. How can I say the engineers are important, and then the there's very tight or squeeze in the Japan. That's why the you came here. So how do you think the potentials of the engineers in the Thailand?
Thailand, Thailand, old Japan, almost same. Then I'm old Japan, first technology I have experience and knowledge very much. Then maybe use if you can need knowledge together and work and make happy in Thailand.
So you'll be a good reader to demonstrate the your mind, engineer mind, and then the perhaps the Japan may follow your models of the creating innovations, I hope.
Yes, thank you.
So, let me ask you about we have the engineers from Japan, Mr. Kato. not engineer, but the technology providers. So how do you think, Mr. Nagao, how do you think the collaborations with such the Japanese international companies?
Of course. I think that's about areas. That's the area of the ideas need a lot of the investment for a major Japanese industry to operate and to make a large profit in this area is very difficult, I think. Like small company,
Mr. Kato, do you want to support him?
Yesterday night we discussed.
Very good. So we had potential innovations here.
So let me have another question. Next is about the So I understand Mr. Nagao is the leading innovator in the Bangkok or Thailand. So you have a very good collaborator, the Mr. Rakjit. So the I just have a question, Mr. Rakjit. What kind of supports can you provide with the Japanese vendors or other international workers, as a local the technical provider?
Yes, actually, we also collaborate with him. We as last time he came with the funding and works from Japan. So we provide our workers, our engineers to collaborate with them and learn with them also, because we know a lot how as Chulalongkorn University surveying department, so we have so many people really good on surveying. So we help them on the newest, latest technology from Japan to provide the service and fulfill the engineering and technical part. Yes.
So I understand that there will be a firm collaborations from the concept to the basic techniques or human resources so important regarding the use of the code technology in Bangkok and Thailand. So next, I'd like to know more about the HAII activities. On the may I ask you the first about the we already have the very good the high precision technologies, and also the real time the monitoring or something. But your interest is in the water resource disaster management. So continuous monitoring is important. So sustainability of such a system is needed, I think. So how do you have any ideas or needs, problems, issues about the sustainabilities of the systems from HAII?
That is the good question. In my opinion, management for sustainability should be start from the network, and then we should find a partnership such as from the include public sector, private sector, and also academy. After we have the partnership already, and then maybe we should find for the long term plan. We should find how to make the cost for maintenance in GNSS technology infrastructure, such as the maintenance core and the system, and how to develop the service. Also, this part should provide from the government sector, private sector, and also from the user. And I think after that, now we know GNSS technology widely, but I think we should promote the technology, how to use it, and how to get the benefit from the GNSS technology for their business, for user business, and for several applications, such as what is the opportunity that we use GNSS technology. And we can promote by the success example and the knowledge sharing, technology transfer, and also a good practice to user, also demonstration and experiment. I think this part is very important, that it have could find the partner and get many example for user. And after that, I think if they know about what is the useful for them, I think they would like to use it and can use it in the sustainable long term.
Thank you. So the collaborative network, such as technology transfer or collaboration project, international also included?
Yes.
also include.
Yeah, so those will be, will support your visions of the providing the technologies for the resource water resource management, disaster risk management. Okay, thank you very much. So I would like to have a bit technical question about the real time. So the high precision positioning of the, especially the moving objects such as cars, the supported by the real time the communications. But the I heard that the 3D the communications are likely to be good in Bangkok. So how about the such communication issues, communication technology issues, in Thailand? May I ask about the status on the to Mr. Raghdi.
Okay, for the communication now for our experience on the testing field is good, right? However, we're not sure across the country what this is. So before we implement anything, we need to do testing first. However, as we experienced the first time for me, the VRS from Topcon on the moving car, really fast moving car, very fast. So it's quite the new experience, because before that we used the RTK system with fixed reference station. So with VRS it's really easy and simple to when the car move around the Bangkok from center of Bangkok to AIT to Rangsit. Yes, we don't need to change anything. So this is good, and with really good communication, yes, it's best.
Thank you. I think that Mr. Kato also do have some experiences in
yes,
the issues.
During we installed the T-Net, and actually some of the station we using that 4G network only to reducing the cost. And actually speed is very good, and very unstable connections. So I heard that one of that our distributor tested about 5 years ago that was not successful because of that connection. So that I would say that this 4-5 years. This communication technology here, I can say, also we have tested some other country like Indonesia, Singapore, okay, but Malaysia, then most of the people complain the connecting to the RTK, VRS, the connect, disconnect. So here actually, currently Bangkok is good. So I hope the cause network expand entire Thailand, maybe this kind of a connection hopefully expand entire Bangkok, entire Thailand.
Well, thank you very much for sharing your experience. So we have the very good, enough good infrastructure in the last few years. So because the time is a bit limited, I'd like to conclude this round table session, but we may have the questions from audience.
Thank you. I'm from NECTEC. I'm a researcher from NECTEC named Monsak. I have question for three speakers and also the one discussion. Let me start from the discussion because it's related to the issue that we just mentioned, the communication. Correct me if I'm wrong. In my understanding, if we use RTK, we need continuous connection. We use data stream, right? Cannot be disconnected at all. But for the differential GNSS, because it is based on single frequency, and as I know, it doesn't require continuous connection, does not need data stream. And it also provides submeter level accuracy around 50%, 50 centimeters. So why not be considering the differential GNSS instead of RTK? Please share your opinion.
But the, in the near future that this kind of the L6 satellite comes, then the if a receiver has a capability to receive that on that meter or centimeter accuracy, so maybe some of the customer doesn't require that some of the customer doesn't require that RTK network RTK accuracies, but let's say for the machine control, we require that very much precise accuracy, like 1-2 centimeter accuracies. So that's why that we believe the so then as you mentioned a disconnect issue also there, but still we believe that this slightly different segmentation still remain. One is for that L6 receiving that PPP or the SSR, but still this kind of the much higher accuracy network will be used. That is my thought. Also, cause network is not only for just sending that high accuracy data, also using for that earth tectonics data, continuous movement, something, a lot of the other application also there, even itself in the cause networks. That is my understanding.
Okay, now questions for Mr. Kato. The current 10 core station that you just installed, you said, is this under operation already? It's providing the augmentation RTK service. It's provide the augmentation for all the constellation, right? Including Galileo and Pluto and QCSS. Okay. And is it also provide differential collection for GNSS? Include also differential GNSS? No, just RTK.
Yes, just a network RTK only. Mm. Yeah, signal currently no.
Can you?
I need to talk to my engineers.
Okay, please talk and we discuss later.
Yeah.
Another issue is the, okay, please share your experience in Japan about the ionospheric turbulence. Because how do you resolve this kind of issue in Japan? When it happens, the accuracy will increase very sharply. How do you resolve in Japan?
I understand that this is one of the issues. Thailand has a lot of the thunderstorm and the cloud, sudden cloud comes. So that I think in Thailand, more issue, much the this is an issue more get accuracy down. So this I think we need to share this kind of information with the some of the university like the AIT or Chulalongkorn University to share this kind of information. Then I want to ask the other one of the teams to for the student to solve. Investigate and give some answer to us actually. So we are more manufacturing part, so that we are not so much specialists to solve this kind of issue. So as a Thailand for a new differentiate as a to solve that kind of issue, maybe we need some collaboration with the education parts.
Because this is a very important issue. Let me show example. Suppose I am doing precision agriculture using autonomous vehicle, and during I do the operation, if this turbulence happens, the accuracy will drop very sharply. And what can how can I know in advance, or how do I manage when this happens?
I suppose the that's why that the. This is one of the reasons we installed that the TNET here. Then that we want together to solve this kind of problem. Then this kind of utilize this network, then solve one of this kind of problem. Then that then the now entire Thailand core network start, we already solve that kind of issue. So that again, that we like to utilize the current our TNet, then to together to solve this kind of issues.
And also this for all the Japanese, because I learned today that you have done a lot of experiment in Thailand, and I guess the report will be conducted in Japanese. I would like to you to also develop the Thai versions, and if you have no technical person to help on writing the report, I'm volunteer to help you doing that. Please contact.
We have to conclude.
Okay.
So do you have important questions to share? Or you can discuss with Mr. Carter.
Okay, I will discuss with the other two later. Okay, the one most important question is for Mr. Nagao, just one. For dynamic map. I hope that Japan also have collaboration with the local company on developing dynamic map for Thailand, so that our engineer have expertise on doing this. Please.
So thank you very much for the participation in this session. Also, please approach the invite experts the speeches. So thank you very much.
I would like to say thank you very much to all panelists, and big thank you to Dr. Hiroyuki Miyazaki for managing and moderating this panel. And all the panelists, please remain on stage. Next, I would like to invite Dr. Shawalit Silapathong, Deputy Director of JISTA, to come up in the front to give the souvenir to the panelists. แล้วก็สำหรับทุกท่านนะคะที่ได้รับแบบสอบถามค่ะก่อนที่จะเข้ามาอยู่ในงานนี้นะคะช่วยกรอกแบบสอบถามให้ครบค่ะแล้วก็สำหรับท่านใดที่มีคำถามอะไรสามารถที่จะเขียนลงไปได้นะคะที่แบบฟอร์มแล้วก็นำไปส่งคืนที่จุดลงทะเบียนค่ะแล้วก็เดี๋ยวเราจะไปพักเบรกรับประทานอาหารกลางวันกันนะคะบริเวณชั้น2ที่ห้อง207ถึงห้อง212ค่ะAlright, please complete the form that you got in the beginning. And if you have any questions, you can write it down on the form and send it back to the registration desk. And we will have lunch together on the second floor at the room number 207-2212. Thank you.